Hello students, now we will be dealing with the last topic in your syllabus, which is called as a Bayesian learning. So most of you must have come across this concept of Bayesian learning or the Bayes theory, because it mainly deals with probabilities. Lot of probabilities come into picture when we talk about Bayesian learning or the Bayes theory. Basically, why it is important in machine learning is it will allow us to predict the probability of whether a hypothesis holds or not. Okay, and it helps us to manipulate algorithms based on those probabilities. So that is why, because this entire concept of probability comes into picture, this is a very important topic in machine learning. Okay, now when I talk about the first thing, what we are going to talk here is about first let me tell you what is a probability. Probability is you are predicting the occurrence of an event. Okay, like for example, I toss a coin. Now you all have seen IPL, right? There's a coin toss. So they predict what can be the probability whether heads occurs or tails occurs. In Bayes theory, when we talk about Bayes theorem, certain terminologies come into picture over here. One is called as a prior probability. Another is a posterior probability. Okay. Now let's see what a prior probability is. Now I took an example of your IPL match, which all of you are familiar with. You see the Indian, if you take RCB, since we are, if you take RCB as a team, the captain of RCB, Virat Kohli, comes, the first thing what they do with the opponent team, both of them are asked to say whether it is head or tails. So then they are saying head or tails even before the coin toss. It is some prediction they are trying to make. So even before seeing the data, what is the data over here? The coin toss is the data. So before seeing the coin toss, they are predicting whether it is a head or a tail. That is what we call as a prior probability. Okay, so before seeing the data, what I do, say Kohli comes and he says it is heads. Okay, that is a prior probability. Now then the umpire tosses the coin, or whoever is tosses the coin, after the coin toss there is a probability that is called as a posterior probability. Has the head occurred, has the tail occurred, means after seeing the data you make a prediction, that becomes a posterior probability. Okay, so prior means before seeing the data, if I make a prediction, that is called as a prior probability, and posterior probabilities after seeing the data I make a prediction. So this is for a particular hypothesis. Whatever probability I am doing, it is for a hypothesis. What is a hypothesis? Toss can result in a head or toss can result in a tail. That is the hypothesis. So this is called as P of H. Okay, your prior probability is called as P of H. Now in addition to this, we have another term called as probability of D. D is what? The entire data. Okay, it has got no relevance to what your output hypothesis is. Nothing. I just have the set of data over here. Okay, so that data, the probability of having the data, is what we call as P of D. So P of D is, this is prior probability that training data will be observed. Okay, P of H is just the prior probability. You are making some prediction even before seeing the training data. And P of B is the probability that the training data will be observed. Now, D given H, that is probability of observing data given the hypothesis. So like for example, I'll say the the data, the hypothesis is the floor is wet. Okay, now if I see a wet floor, it could be, one reason could be that it has rained, right? So I am seeing a wet floor, then I am trying to assume or predict that has it rained or not. So the hypothesis here is has it rained or not, and the data will be the wet floor or the other way. So I am seeing one, this is probability that one is given and I am predicting the other. So hypothesis is given and I am predicting the data. Okay, that is P of the given H. Now here in Bayes' theorem, we are trying to predict P of H given D. That means what is the hypothesis when the data is given to you? As I told you, data is a wet floor. Okay, now I am assuming that if when I am entering a room, or not a room actually, when I go outside, step outside the house, if I find a wet floor, what is the hypothesis that it has rained? What, how much can I predict? What is the probability that it has rained? That is what we call as P of H given D. Probability of the hypothesis when I know what the data is. So this is what we try to predict in your Bayes' theorem. And how we predict this is using these parameters. Okay. So probability of H given D is nothing but probability of H given D is equal to probability of D given H into probability of H, which is a prior probability, by the probability of the data. This is what we call as the Bayes' theorem. The derivation is not relevant. Actually, this again, the derivation comes from the sum and product rules of probability. So from that we can derive your Bayes' theorem, but since it is not relevant for you, I will go into detail about that. Okay, this is clear, I hope. So what is Bayes' theorem? You are predicting what the hypothesis is based on the data which is given to you. So that is the formula using your prior probability and the data set. Okay, now we will define what is a maximum or posteriori. Okay, this is also called as H maximum or posteriori. Now, how we get this is, now I know what is the Bayes' theorem now. P of H given D is P of D given H into P of H by P of D. Now, this is the prediction we see, we make after seeing the data. Supposing I have, say, 1000 patients. Okay, now in which there are 900 patients who are having a disease and 100 patients who are normal. I have a set of 10 doctors. Now these doctors, when the patient comes in, based on some prior probability, the doctor should predict whether he or she has a disease or not. Okay, so imagine the first doctor predicts, he makes a prediction of 0.8, second doctor makes a prediction of 0.3, third doctor makes a prediction of 0.6, and so on. Say fourth doctor makes a 0.01, fifth doctor makes 0.9. Okay, now afterwards when we see the data, actually we find that actually the patient, this is for first patient, patient 1. Okay, I have about 5 doctors over here. Each one, based on some statistics or based on some features, they are making a certain prediction. Now after these predictions, this is called as prior probability. Before seeing any data, they are making this prediction. Now after, later we find that, say, the patient 1 who came in had a disease. Okay, so he is a patient who has a particular disease. Then what you have to see, the highest probability among these doctors is this. That means this will become the best probability match. So what we are doing over here, we are finding the probability of each individual doctor. So P of H, say I have D1 as the first doctor, then I have D2 as the second doctor, this way. Now I value, which is called as a maximum a priori a posteriori probability. Okay, so how we write that? It is just the H max. Nothing else but maximum of the probability of x given b for all the hypotheses. Okay, so what is an x given b? We have not considered the denominator because it is same for all. So okay, first we will write the same formula. This is nothing but probability of b given h into probability of h by probability of b. Again, R max, argument max, h belonging to h. Okay, now we remove the d because the data is same for all the values. So this is equal to R max of h belonging to h, probability of d given h into probability of h. Okay, this is called as the maximum or posteriori probability. Okay. Is this clear? I hope this is clear.